Hello, I'm KCRA 3 meteorologist Dirk Verdoorn, and taking a look at what's going to be happening here over the next several days. As we have the colder air has already moved in. We've been dealing with some snow in the Sierra. We've had a few little sprinkles and showers here across the valley. That is going to increase over the next several days. So right now we just have that cold air in place. So temperatures starting off Wednesday morning in the 30s will be warming only into the mid to low 50s by later on this afternoon. There will be periods of sunshine, a few clouds, and an increasing chance for some sprinkles and showers as we head through the afternoon and on into the evening. I think the bigger change will be in the Sierra. Again, we have a bit of a break, and then we'll see more snow picking up in the mountains. And with that colder air, we're talking about some lower snow levels as well. So futurecast showing us, again, not a lot of activity through Wednesday morning and into early afternoon. We do see things picking up though as we go into the afternoon with some showers here in the valley and some more snow picking up in the Sierra. Most of the activity will be in the mountains, but we could see just little pulses of shower activity working their way down to the lower foothills as we head into early Thursday morning. Here we are about 2:30 a.m. and you can see that we have some potential for some snow in low elevations in Placer County, and expect to have that increase as we go through Thursday afternoon. Winds will also pick up a bit on Thursday, so it'll be breezy on Thursday. Wind speeds generally 15 to 20, gusting between 20 to 30, and the chance for rain that will be on the increase through the late afternoon and on into the evening. It's really Friday, especially early Friday morning, that some of the stronger winds will come through, and we'll see that snow really pick up in the Sierra, and we'll see the rain definitely on the increase as well here in the valley. And we could see some low snow again on Friday morning. Here we are about 6:30 a.m., and you can see that we have some, again, low snow possible in places like Glenn County, Colusa County, Yolo County, even into San Joaquin and Stanislaus counties, and then into the low foothills and spots that are, you know, just anywhere below 500 feet possible with some snow there in the foothills. That will taper off. We'll still see the snow in the upper elevations as we go through Friday afternoon. In the valley, it's going to be more of a chance, I think, with instability for some thunderstorms to pop up Friday afternoon as the core, where the coldest air is with this weather system, slides south right around the Bay Area, moving towards Southern California. So let's take a look at your wind forecast. Wednesday, we'll have the winds more towards the Bay Area. Valley spots, not too bad. Winds do pick up on Thursday. We'll get southerly winds. That will be fairly light in the morning, but we'll see those wind speeds more likely between 10 to 20 miles per hour through Thursday afternoon, with gusts between 20 to 30 miles per hour. And then those winds really intensify as we head into early Friday morning. Here we are, 2:30 a.m. We could see wind speeds that could be anywhere between 25 to 35 miles per hour. That means gusts are going to be up over 40 to 45 plus miles per hour. So that's when we're going to see some of the strongest winds move through the valley. And then those winds start to taper off, still a little breezy as we go into Friday afternoon. And then we get set up for a better weekend. So as far as snow, we are looking at low snow. And we could see some pretty good accumulations at some of those lower elevations. Again, we could see upwards, again, total, this is through Thursday, through Friday, and into Saturday morning, we could see several inches down around 1,000 feet. And so that's where we're going to see some of the bigger impacts that are going to be in the lower elevations, where we don't typically see that much snow. We are looking at some great amounts of snow also over the passes. We could see a few feet of snow. We're talking 2 to 3 feet of snow or more in some spots. So futurecast shows, again, the long range here, we have these pulses or waves coming through over the next several days. Wednesday into Thursday. Thursday, things start to pick up. Friday is when it really starts to hit pretty good with the rain and the snow and the wind. And then things taper off on Saturday, so a little bit of a break, but more comes in on Sunday. And we could start seeing that as early as Sunday morning, getting some more rain and some more snow. And then right behind that, come Monday, another system moves in Monday afternoon, and we are looking at that lasting on into Tuesday and then clearing out by Wednesday. So we have a very active weather pattern. Impact days for Thursday and Friday because of the low snow. We're looking at a chance for some scattered showers today even, but look at those temperatures dropping off into the upper 40s to lower 50s. And we're going to stay below average through the next 7 days and stay active with a chance for more rain as we head into next week. That's a look at your forecast. For all your weather needs, make sure you turn to KCRA.